Hi, I'm David Kang. Thanks for watching my presentation on income property. I'd like to share with you some of the ideas that have made my clients and I successful real estate investors. Now, this presentation is not designed to sell you anything, so just sit back, relax, and enjoy the information. That being said, my attorney says I need to read you something first, in case some of you try to remove your own appendix right after the presentation. The presenter, David Kang, does not make any representation or warranty, expressed or implied, as to the accuracy or completeness of the information contained in this presentation. This presentation is educational only and cannot be relied upon to make any decisions. The viewer must retain and consult a duly licensed and insured attorney, accountant, and investment advisor prior to making any decisions. By continuing to view this presentation, the viewer hereby agrees to be bound by these terms and agrees to forever release and hold harmless David Kang from any and all claims arising from the viewing of this presentation. This presentation does not constitute an offer to sell or a solicitation of an offer to buy real property. David Kang holds a Nevada real estate salesperson's license with Realty One Group Incorporated, 10750 West Charleston Boulevard, number 180, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89135, United States of America. Okay, with that said, let's talk about a little blue sky thinking. What do you want? This is actually a more complicated question than most of my clients have taken the time to answer. And if you really think about it, with our busyness in the day-to-day life, we don't get a chance to answer it either. I'll tell you what some of my clients have said. Almost all my clients say that they want health. In other words, they want to feel good, they want to be healthy. If, for instance, you do something very dangerous every day to earn money, you may not be around to enjoy the fruits of your labor. Neither my clients nor I want that, and I bet you probably don't either. Almost all of my clients say they want to be happy, don't we all? And of course, if you're viewing this presentation, you're thinking, show me the money, right? Both my clients and I can relate. Everybody wants a little bit more money. A lot of my clients say that spirituality is very important in their lives, and almost everyone says that they want a new, nice car every few years. So what are we talking about? Well, this is not a quote-unquote Kool-Aid drinking presentation. Kool-Aid's a registered trademark of the Kraft Foods Company. We won't be doing any meditation, transformation, staring at our navels, holding hands, or singing songs. This is a very pragmatic presentation. There's nothing wrong with those activities, by the way. It's just not what we'll be doing here. When we start to talk about what people want, both my clients and I realize that we're really talking about options. We want the option of being able to go to the Caribbean at the drop of the hat. We want the option to visit Italy during the summertime. We want the option to take our spouses to Paris to see the Eiffel Tower. And for me, most importantly, I want the option of going to a restaurant and ordering whatever I want to eat without worrying about what the tab is going to be when I'm finished eating. So all this talk about options really brings us back to the question, well, how do we get all the options? It may seem obvious to you, but the two words are cash flow. And specifically, I'd like to qualify that by saying passive cash flow. The difference between passive and active cash flow, of course, some of you may know, is that we don't have to work for our passive cash flow. In other words, our money is working for us, or we control assets that generate money without us going to work every day. This isn't so far-fetched. Imagine if we had assets that created enough passive cash flow to pay for our house, our food, our car, our children's educations, whatever expenses we would think of normal and necessary to our day-to-day lives, which keep us from doing what we really want to do. Having passive cash flow gives us those options. It gives us those freedoms. I'd like to share with you a very concrete example now. We've been talking somewhat conceptually, but this is an investment property one of my clients has recently purchased. For those of you who are a little bit numbers adverse, just skip to the bottom line. This client stands to make about $200 a month from this investment property. Now, I know what some of you are thinking. $200 a month is what I spend on coffee. Well, we have to think a little bit more about scale. It's not just coffee we're talking about. If we remember this $200-some-odd a month and really start to think about collecting investment properties. Remember what we played as kids doing that? It was Monopoly. By the way, Monopoly is a trademark of Hasbro. If you've got one investment property, it's really not that interesting. But as the numbers increase, you've got more and more of these things. It turns out when you got about 16 investment properties, 16 doors or keys, as some people like to call them, you're talking about $3,400 a month. That's a pretty decent car payment. And in some areas of the country, that's a house payment. It gets even more interesting as you continue the example. At 128 doors, which by the way is not unrealistic, think about the first apartment complex in which you might have lived. In the western United States, 128 units is a relatively small apartment complex, certainly in Las Vegas. But if you own 128 doors, you're going to earn $328,000 a year, top 3% of earners. In other words, 97% of all other people would make less than you, and you wouldn't be working for a living. You would have the option of working, of course, but again, that would be your option. Even my most ambitious clients think that a 512-unit portfolio could be one apartment complex, it could be several, that made them $110,000 per month, or $1.3 million a year, would be an acceptable lifestyle. All this talk of options is really interesting. Bringing it all back, what we want is the options, but we also want the time. This is where investment property has done wonders for my clients, and it can help you too. Investment property can generate enough passive cash flow so that you get your time back, so that you've met your expenses. And then once you've met your expenses, if you continue to grow your portfolio, investment property can generate you the money to enjoy your time. So speaking of time, we're unfortunately out of time for this particular episode. I hope you'll join us next time to look at the mindset of an extraordinary investor. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.